coins. Yeah, I've been collecting them for about a few months now. They just keep coming. I collect one and another appears somewhere else. People don't really get it. They think it's a waste of time. But the coins, they don't really have a purpose. I know they will, though. I know they will.
Can I start off by saying how cool this is? A few videos ago, anything that I wanted to add into my game was this huge process of figuring out how to implement. Even the smallest additions took trial and error just to get it semi-functional. But now, I'm able to add some improvements a lot quicker. Here's some of the smaller changes I made. I made a back button in the settings menu. I still don't have any settings to change, but I felt a back button was necessary so when I give the game to someone else to play, they're not forced to reset because they're stuck in the menu. I also added a main menu button on the game over screen, as well as the pause screen for some quality of life. Finally, I added a red layer outside of the arena, and the bullet laser thing that the player shoots no longer overlaps the player. Then I got this. In my last video, I was having an issue where the bullet went a little past the barrier before it was finally Q-freed, and I couldn't figure out why. I tried troubleshooting, but I think it's pretty complicated because nothing seemed to work. Raycasts have been something that I've heard a lot about from watching devlogs on YouTube, but until now, I've never used one. Tayo suggested that I give it a try, and I can already see so much use for them. I always thought they seemed complicated before since I didn't really understand them, but after seeing how he was using them in his game and also walking me through implementing one on the bullet, I'm looking forward to using them more. And look, the bullet isn't going past the barrier anymore. Now for the shop. There are a few things we need to think about. Spawning, the UI, and the sprite. And also probably a million other things that I'm not thinking about because I've never done this before, but that's a problem for future me. Let's start off by making a sprite. Alright, anyone out there who's great at pixel art, please tell me this is how your art looked when you first started out too. And if it isn't, please lie. Hopefully this sprite is going to change in the future, but at least it'll give me something to put into the game so we can make it do something. Let's move on to spawning. We need to make sure that it's only going to spawn inside of the arena, but we already made something like that for the coin. I really don't want to duplicate the same code I'm using for the coin because if I need to make a change to it in the future, I'll need to change it in two places instead of one. What I did instead is I extracted the code from the coin node and I put it in its own node called spawn in bounds. This node is listening for custom signals when it's time to generate a new position for the coin, or now the store, and will send that position to whatever node is requesting them. Cool, so that handles how the shop is going to spawn. But what about when? I'm thinking that after a certain number of points, say 500, the store will spawn somewhere randomly on the map. I don't want it to stay there forever though, so to make it interesting, I'll also set up a timer that will trigger the store to despawn after a certain amount of time. I tried a 10 second timer at first, but that seemed a little too short, so I changed it to 15 and it seems much better. So we have a store, but what's it going to sell? There's a lot of opportunity here, so let's start off with two things. First, I want it to sell a shield. This will give the player a second chance if they're hit by an enemy, which I feel is invaluable, especially in the later waves. After all, it's not very fun living for so long and then losing after one little mistake. For the second item, I kinda wanna give the player the ability to shoot. But wait, can't the player already shoot? I'll be taking that. I think it might be cool to start the player off forced to run away with no way to defend themselves. Then, when the player can afford it, I want it to feel that much more rewarding. I did have to adjust the enemy spawn rates in the beginning to compensate for this, though. It felt a little too annoying at the rate they were spawning, so I decreased it a bit just for the beginning. Now let's work on this UI. I still have a lot to learn with how to make menus in Godot, but I think I'm slowly figuring it out. Slowly. After a few tries with adding and moving around different control nodes, I felt like I needed to step back and organize things in my head. I needed to visualize how this was going to look. Wow, that actually really helped. And what's this beautiful sprite here, you may ask? That's the shield, can't you tell? We may have items in the shop, but they still don't do anything yet. So let's change that. The laser is the easiest because the functionality is already there. All I have to do is add a variable that determines whether or not the player is allowed to shoot, so when the laser is bought from the shop, the variable is changed from false to true, and we have a shiny new laser. The shield is a little more involved. Adding it to the player when it's bought from the store is easy enough, but then it needs to protect the player. I think we can do it though, as long as we avoid some obvious bugs like pushing enemies around, triggering a game over, or crashing the game completely. It shouldn't be too hard. Okay, I think it's finally working. Check it out. We're able to go into the store, buy a shield, and apply it to the player. It's a child of the player, so it's going to go everywhere the player goes. Not only that, but I added a short window of invincibility when you run into an enemy and lose your shield. I didn't think it would be fair if you died like 2 frames after losing your shield, so for 3 seconds, you're intangible, allowing you to get to safety. I added the blinking effect to let the player know they're invincible, and I was able to do this with 2 timers, with one controlling the invincibility, and the other one controlling the frequency of the blinks. When activated, the shield is looking for a collision with something from the enemy group, and when that happens, it calls a function to deactivate the shield and start the invincibility and blinking timers. With that done, there's also just 2 small changes that I made. First, I gave the menus a nice blue background. I think it's an improvement. Second, I added a 3-second timer at the beginning of the game, when you close out of the store, and when you close out of the pause menu. I wanted to give the player a chance to get ready before jumping back into the action. I've been learning a lot about game development with every new thing that I add, but there's still an area that I haven't touched yet, and I think that should be next. This should be interesting. Thanks to everyone who's been helping me and giving me tips as I try and figure out game dev for the first time. If you have a tip or just want to say hi, leave a comment. I read them all, and it's been great interacting with everyone. See you in the next video.